Hi, Kerry here from My Quick Bookkeeping. My GST return is due, so I thought we'd prepare it together. The first thing I do before starting any submission to the government is to ensure all my accounts are up to date. I do this by reviewing my balance sheet on the last date of the period we're doing a return for. For example, for me now, that's May 31st. I've made a previous video to show you how to run your balance sheet, so if you're not sure how to do that, you can select that video in my channel below. As I've already reconciled everything, we can go to the screen and complete the return. Before I start, I always run a balance sheet. So we pop here to reports, and I have it as one of my customized reports. I'm going to need to run it for the period that I'm doing the return for. So that would be 1st of March to the 31st of May. There we go. I run that report. I scroll down and have a look and see what the GST payable is. For that period, it's $135.56, so I make a note of that on a piece of paper. Then, I select sales tax on the left-hand margin. You can see here Receiver General is the one who's come up. There's also possibly one here for Minister of Finance, which is PST. But today we're filing the GST return, so this is the one that I want. So the next return to file here is the one beginning the 1st of March. It doesn't have the correct ending date. I'm going to pop in to prepare return. I'm going to change this end date to be the 31st of May. Here it is. And here we go. The amount is exactly the same as what we wrote on the balance sheet. It's just always a nice double check to make sure you're in line. So now here we have a breakdown of tax collected, tax paid, and the amount that is due. So I now mark as filed. So all done. This will mark my return as filed and close the books for the period. So I'm going to continue. Now we need to file that return with the Receiver General and actually do it on the CRA website. Let's open up this return so we have all of the summary. This is the information we're going to need to enter into the website. This is the Government of Canada website for GST HST NETFILE, and I'm ready to file. So read through these points here, make sure they're all okay before you click continue. Then you'll come up to the screen where you enter your business number, access code, and reporting period. I'm not going to film those bits, I'm just going to do them and then we'll move to the next screen together. So after entering the information about your particular business, you'll come to this screen where you're able to enter in all of the information from the return we just prepared in QuickBooks. Once you've done that, make sure that the amount here at the bottom agrees to the amount that we've written down on the piece of paper and is the bottom of your sales tax return. I'm just going to do that right now. Now let's press calculate. Here we have our same $135.56. Yes, I will make a payment within the next 5 days and everything is accurate, so I submit the return. And now the return's filed. You still need to go and make a payment though, so I don't know if you're either going to do that online or if you're going to be able to do that through internet banking. But one way or the other, that payment still needs to be made by the due date, as you can see here, minus the 30th of June.
If everything's been set up properly in your QuickBooks Online file, that should be a very smooth exercise. If not, we can help. I'll also be adding a video to show you how you can set up products and services in your QuickBooks file that'll help you to keep your taxes in order. If you watched me post imported transactions in a prior video, you'll see how that can make life much easier. If you'd like to sign up for QuickBooks, you can do so using the link below. If this has been helpful, be sure to click like and subscribe to my channel. If there's anything else you'd like to know about, please make a note in the comments below. My next video could be for you. Cheers.